China has suspended Ant Group's blockbuster IPO in Shanghai and Hong Kong just before its scheduled listing on November 5th, citing major issues. Let's do a three-point analysis to understand what happens to the world's biggest initial public offering. Number one, listing. Alibaba owns a third of the Ant Group. The record-breaking IPO was expected to raise at least $34.5 billion in what would have been the world's biggest stock sale. Retail investors in Shanghai had placed bids for nearly $3 trillion worth of shares. The stock exchanges have said that the listing has been postponed after information by the underwriters that include Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan and China International Capital Corp, among others. Number two, scrutiny. As the company has expanded the range of financial technology services it offers, it has come under increased scrutiny and tighter regulation. Ant Group operates Alipay, the world's largest and the most valuable financial technology company. It is also one of the two dominant Chinese digital wallets in China. We know that Alibaba co-founder Jack Ma has been summoned by the Chinese regulators. A meeting has been set up with Jack Ma and two other senior executives of the company. The People's Bank of China, the China Banking and other authorities had conducted regulatory interviews with Ma and Group's chairman and president as per reports. There are limited details from the meetings, but the company has said in a statement that views regarding the health and stability of the financial sector were exchanged. Number three, new regulations. The People's Bank of China and China's banking regulator released new draft regulations. Among the new regulations are caps on the use of asset-backed securities to fund consumer loans, new capital and licensing requirements, and caps on lending rates. The central bank also raised the registered capital requirement for lenders like Ant to a minimum of around $747 million. Experts think that the new rules can dent the bottom line of the company. The Shanghai Stock Exchange said in a statement that this material event may cause your company to fail to meet the issuance and listing conditions or information disclosure requirements. As the listing is postponed, the company would refund application monies to the investors relating to the IPO.